Now, look. We're sorry about Leanne. The whole joint is. But don't go pushing your luck, because it doesn't make us feel any better about you. And if you start throwing your weight around, God help me, I'll thump you.
You touch her and you'll have to answer to me. Yeah, I mean it, B. Now, we've hurt that woman enough.
See you around, girls.
I want that dough now.
Lizzie, why is this suddenly so urgent?
You saw Josie before. She's real crook, poor little mite. She's got to have that operation, Mr. Reed. She can't wait. She's got to have it now.
Kerry, when are you going to wake up to yourself? How can you be so stupid not to realize how important buyers like that are to your livelihood, not just your livelihood, my livelihood too, sweetheart? Why don't you get bloody wise to yourself? Yeah.
We'll get cracking on that, won't you, Mr. Reed?
I'll get right onto it, Lizzie.
Them government departments can take months just to lick a stamp. And you'll get Marcia in here tomorrow so I can tell her. She'll be worried sick if you don't.
I'll do my best, Lizzie.
Then she'll be here then. Hey, Mrs. Jackson, can I go to the dunny? I've been sitting in there with my legs crossed trying to get this thing sorted out.
Well, off you go then, Lizzie. Then I'll take you to the rec room.
Thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
She's got a heart set on helping Josie. What, are you going to talk to Marcia?
Well, if Marcia's a con, she's going to tell me a pack of lies. And very convincing lies if she's got Lizzie fooled.
Well, what are you going to do then?
I want to get a hold of copies of Marcia's marriage certificate and Josie's birth certificate.
Why?
Both of them should show Marcia's maiden name. If it's not Birdsworth, she's not Lizzie's daughter.
Well, that shouldn't take too long. Mm-hmm.
First of all, I got to get a couple of dates out of Marcia. A wedding date and Josie's birth date.
Well, I wish you luck. Now, how about that other problem?
Oh, Kerry Vincent, that's all under control. I think I've warned David Austin off, but I'll check on the way home tonight just to make sure.
Well, thank goodness something's going right for a change. Mm. Well, I better go and get Lizzie, otherwise she'll start a card game going in the loo. Well, best of luck with Marcia.
Mm.
What you up to? Checking the form for Wednesday's races?
Nothing else to do.
Now, what's eating you?
Certain people have buggered up my whole operation, haven't they? Like getting our radio taken off.
Well, never knew a bookie yet that wasn't a whinger. The girls can still get a bet on. They'll publish the results in the paper.
Half the girls say if they can't have a listen, they won't have a bet. Takes all the excitement out.
Well, you probably saved yourself a packet anyway. Everyone wanted to be on that red sunset in the third.
So why were you telling Lizzie this morning it can't win?
It can't stand favourites.
In or out of jail.
You want a biscuit, Margot?
I wouldn't mind a couple. I'd shove them down your throat.
Listen, will you just play cards, Nolene?
Come on, Bee. Let's play a game of snakes and ladders. Well, what else is there to bloody do?
Oh, you! You stupid little bitch! What are the odds, Margot? She wouldn't last 60 seconds.
About 4-1 against.
Look, this is between me and her.
Listen,
it's between
you?
Who I say
just
it's between.
Just call it, Bee.
Oh, talk to the one who's making the waves.
Sit down, Nolene.
Anytime you want to fight your own battles, puppy dog. Okay, kid, where's this game?
I don't want to play anymore.
Oh, don't worry, Doreen. She'll get hers. They always do.
Yeah, well, I'm still worried about Lizzie and what we're going to do about this Marcia woman.
Maybe we should leave that to Paul Reed.
Yeah, but we're Lizzie's mates. He mightn't do anything.
Yeah, bloody lovely, isn't it, when we have to take over from the social worker?
But you can do it, Bee.
Oh, don't give me that garbage. Yeah, well, we know that Marcia's got a brother called Robert. All we have to do is find out if Lizzie's got a son called Robert.
Yeah.
About poor little Josie. You're gonna have a leg broken all over again. What sort of a doctor would break a little kid's leg?
Look, she mightn't be in as much pain as you imagine, Lizzie. She's managed for quite a while, you know.
Oh, what would you know? I've seen her poor little face all screwed up. It's criminal.
Yeah, well, I think the point is you're getting too involved, Lizzie, and when you're locked up in here, that's bad.
Yeah.
Well, that's what it's all about, isn't it? When I get out of here, I'll have a family of my own. Oh, not that I won't be seeing you and Kev. I'll be around your house every day. Just I won't be under your feet, that's all.
How many sons did you have, Lizzie?
Three. Finest little kids you ever saw.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Richard, Arthur and Robert, wasn't it?
Richard, Arthur and Henry, after my Uncle Henry. He was a horsebreaker up Queensland way. I've got to go and see Mrs. Jackson, stir her up to see Mr. Reed about Marcia coming in tomorrow.
Well, that's it.
Yeah, well, we can't just let him rip Lizzie off.
Don't worry, kid.
Well, what are we going to do, Bea?
I'm not sure yet. But Marcia's not going to get her grubby little hands on Lizzie's dough.
Kerry. Kerry, you there? Have you seen Kerry? Is she here?
No, no, she's not.
What happened to your head?
Oh, nothing really.
I think you'd better tell me, huh?
Yes, I was just lying down up the back. I've got a terrible headache. You better come through. Can I get you a drink?
No, thank you. You have seen her then?
Yes, she was here this afternoon. Drunk and behaving like a bloody lunatic. Well, I might as well tell you, she slugged me on the side of the head with an ashtray, and when I woke up, she was gone.
Have you reported this to the police?
Well, why? She was depressed. She was lonely, and I seem to remember you told me to keep
her. Yeah, all right. Obviously, you've seen a doctor.
Yes, of course I've seen a doctor. It was only a glancing blow, otherwise I'd be dead. I had the devil's damn job explaining it.
I take it, then, that you're not going to press charges.
She's an artist, you know. They're all the same, cut off a bit of an ear, get drunk, get over-emotional. Anyway, I don't need that sort of publicity.
Any idea where she's gone?
Not the faintest. Probably South America. She probably thinks she's killed me.
You don't seem terribly concerned.
Well, no, she was good, but, well, there are lots of others. Well, is there anything else?
Yes, if she does happen to get in touch with you, would you please let me know?
Sure, and just in case you see her first, I suggest you get yourself a crash on it.
Thank you very much. Ta.
You like it?
You ever killed anyone?
Myself?
Yeah.
I can't say I have.
I have.
Listen, you couldn't lend a man a few bob, could you? You know, just to tide me over.
My agent.
What?
My agent, that's who I killed.
Has he got any money?
No, oh, he's loaded. Well, he was.
Listen, do you reckon he'd be good for a few bob? You know, just to tide me over.
I hit him over the head with an ashtray.
I'm having a bit of a rough spin at the moment.
Same as the other one.
Down on the uppers a bit.
You got anywhere to go around here?
What?
You got anywhere to go?
I had my own company, you know. Trucks. I used to sign myself managing director. And I'm having a bit of a rough spin at the moment.
Yeah. I had my chance too, you know. I had my chance and I blew it. I blew it. The cops will be here real soon, you know.